So this afternoon, I want to offer a guided meditation that's going to deconstruct the body. And if for any reason that feels like that would not be the right thing for you now, it's perfectly okay if you want to use this time for meditating outside or maybe doing some movement meditation or something. Because I want to always acknowledge that we can be in different places with what works well for us. Can you hear me all right in the back? Okay, good. So today we're going to be looking at the beautiful and not beautiful, and that often is directed at the body, or using the body as the subject. And so this is one way to work with the true nature of the body and our perceptions of it. So begin by being comfortable where you are sitting. And starting at the top of your head, just bring your attention slowly down your face and head and feel any tightness and invite that to relax. And notice how your shoulders are feeling, your chest and your back, your arms and hands. And just bring some relaxation. And then bringing your attention to your belly, your seat, relaxing, and your legs and feet. And just getting a sense of how the body is doing right now. Then I want you to have an image of your own body in your mind, how it looks right now. And I want you to remove the hair on the top of your head. Just like you could just take it in your hand and take it off like a wig. And lay it down beside you. And notice how that feels. And then I want you to remove your nails, your fingernails. This is all painless. And just take them off. And your toenails. Put them in a little basket. Put it on the floor next to you. And now let's remove the skin. Start at the top of your head and just peel it off. Lay it in a pile next to you. And notice what's left. Our teeth, take out the teeth, put them in a cup. Take out the eyes. Put them on the saucer. Now what do you see? We've got muscles, tendons, ligaments. Remove them all. I know some of them are deep in the body, but just with no trouble at all, take away all the muscles. Put them in a big pile on your other side. With the tendons and the ligaments. I want you to remove all the blood vessels. Any which way you want, you could just start at the heart and kind of take them in your hand and pull the whole system out. Put it in a big bag. And the same for the nervous system, all of the nerves and the spinal cord. We'll leave the brain for now. Just remove all of the nerves. I kind of start at the back of my neck. Pull them all of it together. Set it aside. So now you have full view of organs and bones. Removing the brain, putting it down. And the tongue. And the lungs, just lay them down wherever there's a space, and the heart, the liver, the spleen, the gallbladder, the pancreas. If you're already missing any of these, don't worry. No one's going to take inventory. Remove the stomach. And then we can take out the trachea and the windpipe. I mean, the esophagus was the same thing. Kidneys, bladder, reproductive organs, in case I didn't mention those. So there's this whole cavity. Now, anything else that's still left besides the bones, just take it out, lay it down. Now there's a skeleton. Just bones. And we're going to take the hand bones, all the finger bones, put them in a big basket. And the arm bones, lower and upper. And the skull. And the collarbones and breastbone and ribs, and deconstruct the spine and put it all in the basket. The hip bones, pelvis, leg bones, feet. All the bones piled there in a basket. So we can ask, where are you? Which pile? Now we're going to gradually start putting the bones back where they were. The toes, the feet, the lower legs and knees, the thighs, pelvis. Spine, ribs, breastbone, clavicle, arm bones, upper, lower, hand and finger bones. The neck and the skull. And anything that was missed, the skeleton is back in place. Bring back the brain. The tongue. The esophagus. The trachea. The lungs. The heart, the stomach, the liver, gallbladder, pancreas, spleen, stomach, kidneys, bladder, all the glands and all the rest, the reproductive organs come back. And all the nerves, the spinal cord, and all the nerves back in place. All the blood vessels. Put the eyes back. And all the muscles, of course, below and around and above, internally and around the outside, everywhere, through the body, the arms, the legs, face. Everything under the skin is back on, is back where it belongs. There's an image in the mind of how that looks. Now we reapply the skin. Back on the body, the feet, ankles, legs, buttocks and abdomen, back and chest, fingers, hands, arms, shoulders and neck, face, head, scalp, and finally the hair comes back. And who is this anyway? So we breathe and feel the body. And bring some warm oil, starting at the top of the head, moving down the face, slowly, healing, comforting, over the cheeks and the nose and the chin, and jaw, and then it moves down over the neck, down the front, the front of the shoulders, down the front of the arms, and just feel this warmth. to the fingertips, and coming back to the shoulders. Let this warm oil slowly move down over the chest, stomach, and abdomen. And coming from the shoulders down the back, shoulder blades, spine down the back, low back, down over the hips and the buttocks. The oil comes down on the legs, on the front of the legs. Down the back of the legs. All the way down. Soothing the entire body. And the feet. And then we just come to rest in our breath. With maybe a little more clarity around the body, a sense of what it is and what it isn't. A feeling of wholeness that doesn't come from any part or even the collection, but from awareness. And that the body is not self. And we can observe the body, how it feels, what it needs, care for the body. But know that it's not who we are. It's made up of many parts. To know that it's made of many parts, to see that under the skin, it's not so beautiful. It's to see it more clearly as it is and appreciate it for what it is. And to not get carried away with worries about it, or lust around bodies, but more of a kindness and gentleness and appreciation.